we're going to already see bearish breakout against this line, because you know, this line itself used to be a resistance line for the bullish line of the Bitcoin. As you can see, we're going to see the strong bullish breakout here, right? But it's then turned to be a support line, but we're going to see the bearish breakout, which means the Bitcoin price itself from here, we're going to see drop. Hi, hello, I'm mr.masa. So today is a rewriting Bitcoin weekly forecast and macro updates from February 6th to February 12th. Okay, so let's start. Then this is my portfolio performance as of now. So total return since March 2019 is 618%. Then if you're interested in much more detailed information about my portfolio allocations and also my real-time buy and selling signal for every single crypto assets, including ICO, ID on DeFi, please think about to join my premium membership program, real-time buy and selling signal. The major purpose of this membership program to help you reach your crypto asset performance to my level here. The for more detail, please check out my video. Then here's my video link. Okay. Then let's start here, Bitcoin. So as usual, we're going to check out from S&P 500 Futures daily chart basis. Okay. Then, you know, last week, as I told you that, you know, the currently S&P market, it's now trying to form hit and shoulder bottom pattern. It's one of the, you know, typical, you know, bottom formations, especially long-term bottom formations, right? So usually after this bottom formations, we're going to see, you know, pretty strong in a bridge ramp here. Okay. Then please pay attention to, you know, blue circle mark here. Okay. As you can see, price already hit lower breakout against this blue line trend line. It's bear trend. So usually once we're going to see the, you know, reversal actions against these, you know, blue trend line, it's a hit on the shoulder bottom pattern, especially, you know, they're going to complete the neckline test. Then we're going to see, you know, after, you know, breakout, neckline test, and the sharp break goes up. This is a typical, you know, hit on the shoulder bottom pattern. But eventually, looks like they're going to fail, all right? But it's not the end of the, you know, bullish line, okay? The point is, you know, still, I do think this market trend line is throwing up, you know, this red trend line, as I show you. It's a short-term bull run. Still, you know, price is throwing up this trend line, okay? Then, but, you know, it's inevitable for us. We're going to see, you know, some, you know, bearish price action from here, okay? Then current my target is, you know, around, you know, 0.618 to 0.5, you know, Fibonacci-based one. Price is around 3,900 to 4K, that level. That's my, you know, current, you know, price question targets. But simply say, it's time to be, you know, bear trend from here, okay? Then, which means that, you know, crypto asset markets also heavily affected by, you know, U.S. economy at this moment. So, entire Web3 investment market is also going to bear trend, okay? Then, next one, WTI crude oil, daily chart basis. I think it's still inside the bear trend, but, you know, gradually forming this, you know, bottom price out from there, okay? But, you know, red, you know, those, you know, this kind of short-term red blue trend line, still like not so quite, you know, strong one yet. So they're going to test upper price line, probably this summer or so. That's what I'm thinking about, okay? So no big change. Next one, U.S. inflation rates. This week, on Tuesday, we're going to get the critical updates about, you know, U.S. inflation rate, February 14th. Let's seriously pay attention to this. Because once we're going to see huge drop on the interest rates again here, we might see, you know, bullish line again S&P. Or, you know, short recovery moments into this, you know, midterm bear trend before the brisk summer on the S&P. But if we cannot have, you know, only a small one, small stats improvements on the inflation rates, stock probably goes down. Okay, that's what I'm thinking about. Okay. Then next one, US initial jobless claim plus 7.1%, 196K. Middle level increase. We have to be a little bit cautious on this number here. Okay. Then about the US unemployment rate, no change. Next update timing is March 10th for February stats. Okay. Then, you know, FRB federal fund rate. Last week, we're going to get the updates, February on 4.33%. The next meeting timing is, you know, March 21st. Okay, so much more, you know, around like, you know, 1.5 months ahead from here. Okay. Then, next one, US 10-year Treasury interest rates. Seemingly they were going to test these primary blue bear trend. Because FRB is still, you know, hiking their interest rates. That's why. But still, I think they're going to maintain like bear trend. That's what I'm thinking about. Yeah. Then that's a BTC USDT daily chart. So as I told you, currently critical moments for the Bitcoin is, you know, let's pay attention to these in you know, a thick orange trend line. It's a part of, you know, short-term bullish trend line, red trend line here. Okay. Then as we can see, we're going to already see bearish breakout against this line, because, you know, this line itself used to be a resistance line for the bullish line of the Bitcoin. As you can see, we're going to see the strong bullish breakout here, right? But it's then turned to be a support line, but we're going to see the bearish breakout, which means the Bitcoin price itself from here, we're going to see drop. Okay. So it's the beginning of the bear trend. Then ideal, I hope that the price will stop around the 0.5 and if you want to retest based one, which is around, you know, 20K. Okay. But the volatility of the Bitcoin is quite all the time, very volatile. So we might see a little more further price question to 19K. That's what I'm thinking about. Okay. There is some BTC transaction fee. February 12th, $1.34 minus 27% because we are tied to be a bearish trend. Simple, that's why. Then all market cap and BTC movement slides. No change on the market cap. And the BTC movement slides, 41.22%. 7-day change minus 0.41%. Minus 0.45%. So still altcoin is strong. But it's a typical thing that happens here. All the time, you know, the bullish market trend standing for the Bitcoin. That is why in the beginning of the, you know, entire Web3 asset investment market trend, Bitcoin dominance ratio it goes up. Okay? Then, you know, altcoin bullish trend is follow up. That is why, you know, BTC dominance ratio is going down. Then that's also kind of climax moments. Okay? Then, you know, entire, you know, market cap is going down. Then that's exactly what's happening here now. Okay, so next step, probably next week or 2 weeks later or so, BTC dominance ratio is gradually going up. Because lots of people usually sell their altcoin. That's why. Yeah. Then there's a Google search trend. BTC minus 319. Ethereum NFT no change. The crypto in the minus one. So just exactly happened here. So, you know, retail investor on the internet space not going to follow BTC and crypto anymore because it's time to be a bearish trend. That's also kind of another signal that, you know, bear trend is starting right now. Because, you know, to increase the price of the BTC or other crypto assets, we need more money. So if the retail investor lost their interest, market's going down. Okay, it's pretty natural. Okay. Then key news updates. So still we need to pay attention to these two items. End of January to beginning of February, US major tech stock quarter four earnings call. But probably from the technical analysis perspective, even we're gonna get the pretty good stats here, no, market goes down. Okay, it's kind of things that happen here. Then, you know, also we have to pay attention to US inflation rates. So, you know, this Tuesday is pretty important for us. If you're going to see only small drop on the inflation rates, stock markets much go down further. Okay. Then, you know, Web3 asset markets, including Bitcoin, much go further. Okay. So please remember this. Then next week, major US stock quarter four earnings call will be Coca-Cola and Cisco. Okay. It's going to happen on February 14th and February 15th, respectively. Okay. Then later key news updates. But simply say, I like this tweet. Look at this one. We are born too late to explore the seas, too early to explore the star, just right to fix the money, Bitcoin. Very realistic thinking. I love this. Yeah. The only Bitcoin fix the money problem is the right timing for us to deal with it or focus on it. Okay. Then there's a USD JPY daily chart because I have a lot of Japanese subscribers here. Then still following up the bullish trend, as you can see here. You see this? Still like, you know, following up this, you know, short-term red trend line. Then we already see bullish breakout against, you know, this primary blue trend here. Okay. So from this perspective, you know, still, you know, USD JPY markets is following the bullish trend. Then to me, this price range, you know, around like, you know, 27 to 34 or 35, this range, still kind of safest investment for the USD. That's what I'm thinking about. Because it's almost like in a bottom level on a long-term price range on the USD market. That's why. They basically I'm quite bullish on USD. JPY is getting weak. Okay? I'm pretty confident on this. Okay? Now, as usual, what's the key message at the HODLer? So most people believe that, you know, upper side scenario, I don't know, mindset of the HODLer, but the reality of the HODLer is bottom side scenario. So it's pretty tough work. So what are the key things? Why don't you understand here that if you want to gain bigger investment return on a Web3 investment, be patient. Now here is the result of HODL. So I do think the HODL is best for the retail investor to minimize the risk and maximize the return. Because investment in crypto assets, just like investment in early days of Google and Facebook, then once we can look at the legendary angel investors' traction, such as Longcoin, Peter Thiel, Widerman, all the time, they're going to take the simple investment approach. It's a long-term investment. Then here is another evidence for the Binance research. This is a Bitcoin case, and the longest hold of the Bitcoin also maximize the investment return. In this case, plus 220%. Much larger number than other short number here. So I'm gonna also basically take the long-term investment approach. So I'm gonna also recommend you guys to take the same approach too. Okay. All right, so that is all this time. So I'm gonna make this video for the educational purpose. So I'm not gonna guarantee you any kind of certain endeavor investment outcome with this video and this video that I make. But I truly hope that my video will partly help you guys understand about high potential about crypto and water space. So I'm gonna make a lot of this video crypto and water space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye-bye.